This is Manoj. Welcome to the YouTube channel of MP Bhavaskar. Now, today we will learn about the fixtures. So, what do you mean by fixtures? In the last video, we had seen that is jigs, design of jig. And in this video, we will see what is fixture. If you see the figure carefully, this figure is of milling fixture. This is the fixture and this is the milling cutter. So fixture is what the fixture is doing. Fixture is doing locating the workpiece and holding the workpiece. So in simple words, how one can define the fixture? Fixture is a locating and supporting, also locating and supporting device for the workpiece for ease of operation. It does not guide the cutting tool. In this figure, we can see the milling fixture. So, as I told you, the fixture is used to hold the workpiece and as well as to locate the workpiece. How the fixtures are classified? It is a simple, the name of the fixtures are given according to the application of the machine. If the fixture use on milling machine, it is called as milling fixture. If fixture is used on lathe machine, it is called as lathe fixture. If fixture is used on grinding machine, it is called as grinding fixture. So likewise, it is machine specific. The name is given on the name of the machine to the fixture. So let us see what the fixture does. First understand the meaning of the fixture. I hope that you have understood meaning or definition of the fixture. Fixture, what the fixture does? Fixture only hold the workpiece and guide the workpiece on the machine table. It does not guide the cutting tool. If you compare the fixture with the jig does three functions. It guides the tool, it locates and supports the workpiece. So I hope that you have understood this. Now we will see next slide, that is material for the fixture. Generally, the fixture should be strong. It is, the weight of the fixture is heavy as compared to the jig. Generally, the cast iron is used in most of the time because it has capacity to absorb the shock and damping. It has a capacity to damp the vibrations which are evolved during the machining operation. If you see how we can choose the material, it should be easily available, it should be cheap, and it should be the strength, it should be rigid, and it should be robust, and it should be corrosion resistance, and it has an ability to retain its shape and size under the excessive force applied by the machining processes, or even sometimes clamping process, even sometimes the clamps. The choice of material can be selected depending upon the operating condition. Mostly brass, bronze, steels, sometimes plastics are also used. Now we will see the milling fixture first. Milling fixture contains parts, different parts. There are six parts. First is base, second of course clamp, rest block. The function of rest block is to look, you can say, to locate the cutter. Locating planes are used to locate the workpiece inside the fixture, and gauging surfaces ensures the proper position of the fixture with respect to the cutter. So these are the part. Now we will see what is base. Base is very important part. It is a base plate which is used to clamp that is the fixture. It is a part of the fixture which is used to clamp on the machine table. So it has a, you can say, it has T slots and which are used to fix on the table of the machine. The distance of the T slots, you need to see if the machine changes, means machine one, if we shift from one machine to other machine of different make, that's the distance between the T slot may vary. So you need to design your fixture in such a way that the it should be properly fixed into the T slot of the table. So the main function of the base is to fix the fixture on the machine table. This I told you in the next slide in clearly. Okay. Now, what we will see, generally we do have the two T slots keys which are attached, means it has two slots which are helpful for fixing the fixture on the machine table firmly. So we will see the figure. This is the figure of the base which is used to fix the fixture on the table of the machine. Now I hope that you have understood, because it is very important. Now we will see the things which are required before starting the design of the milling fixture. As I told you, the type of milling machine, because as earlier I told you, as the type of machine had changed, the distance between the T slots is changing. So dimensions of T slots may be changed, dimensions of the T slots and center to center distance. This is very important. It changes as the machine changes. And for that, we can use the different clamps, the strap clamps we can use for that. So one has to take care that we are going to use the same base plate, but the we need to use the strap clamps. So I'll show you the strap clamps, how it looks. This is the strap clamps. You can see, if you see that, this is the bolt and nut arrangement, which, and this is the you can see the clamp. With the help of tightening the nut, it tightens the fixture base. And this is the T slot in which the T is fixed. Okay, so that T-headed bolt is fixed so that it is properly fixed to the machine table. Okay, now generally, as we had seen the base, we also had seen the, if the machine had changed, we need not change the fixture. We have to use the, we can change the strap clamps and we can increase the use of that particular fixture. So but if you see, the proper clamping force should be used. We need to design the clamps in such a way that it should not be loosened, because during the starting of the operation, and that is at the beginning of the operation and at the end of the operation, when workpiece, at the beginning when the workpiece come in contact with the cutter, the vibrations are generated. So these vibrations are need to withstand by the fixtures and the clamps. So one has to design the clamps in such a way that it should withstand the cut, that is at the beginning of the cut and end of the cut. So in this figure number A, they have given the up milling figure, that is conventional milling. In this, direction of feed given to the workpiece is opposite to the direction of rotation of the cutter. So because of that, the tendency of the workpiece at the beginning of cut to come up or to move up. The workpiece may be moving up as the direction is showing. This is, the workpiece is moving up because of this rotation of the cutter. If we, because of this, our clamp should be strong, okay, at the beginning of the cut. And in the, this is called as what, conventional milling or up milling. That's why it is called as conventional milling. And second, in climb milling, or you can say in a down milling, the direction of rotation of cutter, milling cutter, is same as the direction of the feed given to the workpiece. So because of this, one end of the workpiece is pushed down and other end of the workpiece is moving up, lifted up. So this we need to take care, we need to by using proper clamp in the fixture. So it is very important. Now, how, see, truing of the workpiece, what we are going to use, or you can say here, the workpiece should be properly placed on the locating pin surfaces or bearing surfaces, that is pin, pads and plates. So to ensure this, filler gauges of predetermined thickness are inserted. So there should be accuracy of contact between bearing surfaces and workpiece. In terms, fixture base also. So we had seen regarding the workpiece. Now the fixture itself, you need to locate in correct relationship to the cutter. Here also we are going to use the filler. If you see, this is the filler, this is the filler we have used, so that the milling cutter should be located in correct relationship with the cutter. So that, it is very important for this. So use of setting gauge to locate the mill fixture in correct relationship to the cutter. Now we will see the types of milling fixture, milling fixtures. Even now we had seen the types of fixture, now we are going to see the types of milling fixture. So milling fixtures are classified, or you can say milling fixtures are classified according to the clamping, whether it, we have used hand clamping, whether we have used a power clamping, toggle fixture, etc., according to the way of workpiece. So first was according to the clamping, second is according to the way the workpiece is located, such as whether it is located in the V block, whether it is located at center fixture, then also according to the method of presenting the workpiece to the cutter. If your workpiece is having rotary fixture, then it is called as rotary fixture, and okay, under the cutter. Indexing fixture, where the workpiece is indexed into the next position during the machining cycle. See, rotary fixture, you are the, if the fixture is rotating, okay, and indexing fixture, again it is indexed. So according to the milling operation performed, as you know that there are different types of milling operation, face milling operation, slab milling operation. So for face milling operation, if we use the fixture, it is called as face milling fixture, slab milling fixture. If the slotting operation is there, slotting fixture is there. So string milling fixture is also there. So depending upon the operations of milling, the names are given to the fixture itself. So this is all about types of milling fixtures. So now we will see how the string or line milling fixtures look. String or line milling fixture, as shown in figure, the fixture body is there. This is a fixture body and this is the steel clamp. And in this figure, you can see that fiber pad is there and these are all the work pieces. These are all are the work pieces which are arranged in the line. So which are fade in a such in with respect to the cutter. So this is called as string or line milling fixture. So number of component strung behind each other, one by one. This is one workpiece, second workpiece, third workpiece, fourth workpiece, one behind one another, and they are clamp with a fixture body and they are fade against the cutter. So this is called as string milling fixture. Now if you see clamping, if you see, this is the hydraulic this is the hydraulic arrangement, which that is piston and rod. This cylinder, this is a cylinder, this is a piston. If you push that piston and this is the hinge, this will come down also, and which holds the workpiece, this is the lever which holds the workpiece. So here the name is, the clamping is done by hydraulic, so it is called as hydraulic clamping fixture. So what we had seen, hydraulic clamping fixture, string or line fixture, spring type fixture. Now here if you see that cutter is, you can see the location of the cutter. This is the cutter. Now this is the spring, this is the clamp, and because of this spring, this is called as spring type fixture. As you loosen this clamp, the unloading of the workpiece happens because of loosing of this spring. So this is spring type fixture. Now as this is clamp type fixture as usual. Okay, by it is self-explanatory. If you see the figure, one can understand. Now again, sometimes if there are delicate parts, then we have to use the vacuum fixture. Delicate parts which we cannot clamp with the help of excessive force, so it's used suction holding device. So this is the picture of vacuum fixture, which is used for machining of the delicate parts, because they may get bent while clamping force, because of excessive clamping force applied. It works on the vacuum principle. The vacuum is created with the vacuum pump. You can see that atmospheric pores through which it sucks the air, and vacuum is created, and because of that vacuum, the atmospheric pressure acts on the workpiece, and the workpiece tends to stick, and you can perform the cutting operation. So now we had seen the milling fixture, types of milling fixture, that is depending upon the machine. Now we will see the broaching fixture. I hope that you know that what is broaching. Broaching is to cut the splines or square keyway on object. It is either pull type broaching or push type broaching. If you see, this is an internal broaching fixture. This is a machine face plate. If you see, this is machine face plate. This is the workpiece, and this is the broach. Shim is there, work horn is there, and plate adapter is there. These are nothing but the fixtures. These are all the fixtures which fix the workpiece, and through that, which are used to fix the workpiece, and through that, you can see that on the work horn, the workpiece is properly supported and fixed, and through that, the pushing broaching operation is carried out. So it is internal broaching. Again, this is another type of internal broaching fixture. Plate adapter and all that. Workpiece is mounted on work horn, and plate adapter is mounted on the machine face plate. This is the fixture. This is the workpiece. This is the fixture we have used to hold the workpiece, to locate the workpiece, and this is your cutting tool. So I hope that you have understood this broaching fixture. As we had seen the external fixture, now we will see the, we had seen the internal fixture. Now this is the external fixture of, this is the workpiece, and locating, if you see, this is the workpiece, and locating block is there, and broach, you can see that broach. This is the clamping arrangement. One can clamp that workpiece, and so that we can do the broaching operation. So it is vertical type of broaching. Earlier also was vertical type of broaching. So earlier was internal type and now it is external type broaching. So fixture. So main use of fixture is to hold and locate the workpiece. It will not guide the cutting tool. Grinding fixture. Here, as I told you that, grinding fixtures use for holding the workpiece on the table of the machine. Likewise, the milling. So one can use a magnetic chuck plate. See if you see that workpiece is a ferrous material, then magnetic chuck is there and one can fix the workpiece with the magnetic force so that we can do the cutting operation properly. So the grinding fixture use of we can see that it has used a magnetic chuck with the help of magnetic chuck, and here that was a flat magnetic chuck. Here we can see the V block magnetic chuck for the circular block. Generally we do the grinding of flat as well as circular, so for the circular we need to use the V block. So I hope that you have understood this. Now lathe fixture. Lathe fixtures, three jaw chuck is also lathe fixture. Three jaw chuck is used for hexagonal circular workpiece to hold inside the chuck. Three jaw chucks are generally, these are the self-center and they are simultaneously adjusting. Once you unscrew that, the three jaws are there are three Allen keys are Allen slots are there. When you unscrew that, all the chuck will move simultaneously, so it is self-centered also. So lathe fixtures, three jaw universal chuck is a lathe fixture which is used to hold the circular solid circular part or hexagonal part. This is the three jaw. I hope that you have understood. Now if you see that, I told you that this is the Allen slot, Allen key slot. Once you put that Allen key in here, these three jaws will come out. This is a view of three jaws. You can clearly see that. We can also have the four jaw independent chuck, but in three jaw, if we unscrew the Allen key with the help of Allen key, all the jaws will move simultaneously. In four jaw, each jaw can be moved independently. So it is ideal for square, hexagonal and irregular shape workpieces. Even six or eight jaws are also there for special purpose and high standard of accuracy. So but as it has a difference that each jaw can be moved independently in this case, and in earlier case all the three jaws are moved simultaneously. So the four jaw here, the four jaws again, here is the six jaw chucks, four jaw and six jaw chuck. We can see that figure. This is the four jaw chuck figure. This is the six jaw chuck figure. If you count that, six jaw figure. Now, even we can use the magnetic chuck holding iron or steel parts. So thin parts, it is very difficult to hold because of clamping, it may damage. So magnets are used. See, this is the magnetic chuck. This is the magnetic chuck, this is the magnet. If we place our workpiece here, because of magnetic force, it will adhere to the magnetic chuck and you can do the cutting operation. So if the thin parts, which are very difficult to clamp, because of the clamping force, the workpiece may get bent. So to avoid this, we have one can use this magnetic chuck as in lathe. So even the face plates are there. Face plates, circular metal plate fixed to the end of the spindle. Clearly you can see this is the face plate. This is the face plate. Okay, and if you see, this is used to hold work that is too large, and the shape that is cannot be held in the chuck or between the centers. So it has a T slots or threaded holes to hold the workpiece. This is the, if you see that these are the T's, okay, and T bolts, we can say that. Face plates, again this is a face plate which is used to hold the workpiece. It is very, see this face plate, one can say that this job, this is a workpiece, and this is a clamping arrangement with the help of T bolt, and you can do the machining operation with the help of that. Either you can do the turning, or you can do the facing operation, or you can do the grooving operation with the help of lathe machine. So the job which is very difficult to hold in the 3-jaw or 4-jaw chuck, so with the help of face plate you can easily hold that job. And sometimes face plates plays an important role. So these are all fixtures. Even we can see that these are the lathe fixture which are known as collet chuck, which are used for very small parts. Those the small parts which cannot be hold between the chuck. So these small parts can be hold between this collet. Generally it's called as collet chucks. See how the collet chucks, this is the figure how the collet chuck works. This is the tool and this is the collet chuck. In that small part, workpiece is hold. We are holding the workpiece and locating the workpiece, that we have done. So that is called as fixture. That's why it is called as fixture. So mandrel are used if we had seen all the parts which are solid parts in the lathe. Now if the for the hollow parts, we need to give the proper support. So mandrel is used for the hollow part, which in the mandrel, the external diameter of the mandrel is equal to the internal diameter of the hole on the workpiece. So if you see carefully, this is the plain mandrel, this is the plain mandrel, and this mandrel is fixed between, this is a tailstock and this is the your headstock. Between the tailstock and headstock, your workpiece is fixed, and this is a mandrel. This mandrel is inserted into the workpiece and which supports the workpiece, and you can one can perform the turning operation, facing operation, whatever the operation, knurling operation on the lathe. So these are the, earlier you had seen the plain mandrel. The diameter is fixed, but if you want to use same mandrel for the different diameters, you can use the slew type expanding mandrel for high degree of concentration. It provides adjustment of locating for the different diameter, to suit the different diameter. If the variation of the diameter is there, you can expand it and you can adjust the diameter, particular diameter, so that it will hold properly, it will hold the workpiece properly, and you can perform, one can perform the required operation. So even there are threaded type mandrel which are used for the operation. So this is for